in a tight election, every vote counts, of course. And this midterm election in the US next month could be a nail biter in many races. So candidates are making a very big push to get young people out to vote. Now, we know that 18 to 24-year-olds overwhelmingly voted Democratic in 2016 for Hillary Clinton. But there are plenty of young conservative activists who are dedicated to keeping US President Donald Trump and the Republican Party in power. So we wanted to get a better sense of where these young conservatives stand. So my producer, Rick Bastian, and I met with a group of young college Republicans at an American football game at the University of Georgia to get their take. Take a look.
It's game day at colleges across the U.S. Here at the University of Georgia, American football and partisan politics are overlapping this season, whether fans like it or not.
How about them dogs?
Republican Brian Kemp, endorsed by Donald Trump, is in a tight race for governor.
I'm Robyn Curnow from CNN International.
We're not doing any one-on-ones.
Is there anything we can ask him, please?
No time today for one-on-ones.
The Kemp campaign told us they weren't giving interviews. But at this pre-game event for college Republicans, we met a former student-turned-politician who was happy to talk to us over a good old plate of Southern barbecue.
As you can imagine, on a campaign trail, you get a lot of barbecue.
Houston Gaines is 23 years old and a Republican candidate for State House.
I hope we can bring a fresh perspective and some new ideas.
In 2016, a majority of young people voted for Hillary Clinton. Now that Donald Trump is president, up-and-coming Republicans are managing the impact of his policies and his personality.
I think a lot of people wish that, you know, the tweets weren't always what they are. But when you look at policy, I think that's where that's ultimately what matters.
Other Republicans have tried to focus on what they say the president is handling the best.
The economy is important to me. It's about policies, and character isn't our issue.
So you're willing to excuse a lot of the tweets and a lot of, say, the comments around Charlottesville because of the policies?
Reactions like hers reveal the tough conversations being had on campus. Carter Chapman is helping to organize student Republicans.
They like the tax cuts that were passed. They like the idea of keeping conservatives on the Supreme Court.
But he says he's a Christian conservative and doesn't always agree with the president.
I wish that the presidency could be more on message, if anything, and avoid distractions.
At the end of the day, I'm 100% Trump.
Savannah Simpson is 18 years old. And she'll be voting in her first election.
Yes! Oh my goodness, I'm so excited.
She backs even the most controversial Republican issues.
I got a big truck, just in case I need to round up criminal illegals and take them home myself.
Do you agree with that?
I agree, yes. I think that my family, they work very hard, and they work fair, and they earn their money. And so I think that if you're wanting to come to the U.S., I am here to welcome you, but I believe there's a right way to do it.
These students say they're part of the largest membership of college Republicans in the U.S. Despite that, they do have concerns Democrats are seizing momentum.
Democrats on campus are certainly energized, maybe more so than I've seen them since I got here. If that actually translates into votes, I'm not sure.
And candidates for governor, like Brian Kemp, don't want to take any chances.
We got to work hard, because they are. We got to make sure that we get the vote out.